Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name's Tamlyn and this is Sewing on the Tyne, and Happy New Year. Have I said that yet? Is this my first video of 2024? Other than my So Hey Jane unboxing and a video that had been pre-recorded, I think this is. So Happy New Year, welcome to 2024 and welcome to Friday Sews. It's really lovely to have you back on my channel, or to have you here on my channel if you've never visited before. So in this video I'm just going to talk you through a few things that I have picked up recently, some Christmas gifts that I received, some sewing that I've been working on, some plans that I've got coming up. So this is really a Friday Sews that covers the last 2 or 3 weeks, and I'm hoping that from this day forward I'm going to actually be able to keep on top of a weekly Friday Sews as far as possible anyway. So each week there is a prompt question for Friday Sews, and this week it is all about goals and what are your sewing resolutions for 2024. Now I always like to set myself a few little goals, but they're just very casual ones. They're not set in stone, they're not, you know, really really strict that I'm going to beat myself with a stick with if I don't keep to them, if that makes sense. But I do have a few things that I would like to do. I would like to work through my stash. I'm not saying that I'm not buying fabric, because I absolutely will be buying fabric, but I have got some beautiful fabrics in my stash that I would like to dig out. So I need to find some strategies and some ways of working through that. I was watching a really lovely video actually by Carol from Sew Carol. I will link to her channel down below, and she does this really cool wheel of, can't remember what she calls it, wheel of fate or something like that. So she's got this really cool like spinning wheel, like a spinner, and she puts different fabrics on there from her stash, and then she spins it and whichever fabric it lands on she sews up. And I just think that's such a cool idea. And she was saying that one of her viewers suggested using a dice as well, so you could roll a dice and then whatever number corresponds with that fabric, you sew that up. I really love that idea. So yes, I will be trying to work through some of the beautiful fabrics in my stash. I also want to try and get on top of my works in progresses, as always. We know that this is a thing where I tend to skip ahead to the next project before I've even finished the previous one, and that has resulted in quite the stack of unfinished projects, and I would really like to get on top of those to try and get that pile down, because I mean, it's shut in a cupboard at the moment, so out of sight, out of mind, but it is something that could overwhelm me if I let it. I also really want to try and wear more dresses. I tend to, as my go-to uniform of choice, wear jeans and a jumper or jeans and a top. And I would just like to look a little bit more maybe dressy or put together on a day-to-day basis. I'd like to be able to just grab a dress and pop it on rather than always reaching for jeans. So I'm on the lookout, I'm on the search for some dress patterns that are going to fit the bill. In the summer, it's no problem because saltwater slip straight away is my summer uniform. But in the autumn, in the winter, in the colder months, I know I can layer up a saltwater, but I just want something a little bit different. I want something long with a little bit more volume. I don't want puffy sleeves or anything too dramatic. I want something that has waist definition, but looks really nice and put together, and that I can use some of my beautiful viscose fabrics for. So yes, if you've got any suggestions, do send them across, because I'd love to hear some ideas. I'm struggling. I've been doing lots of research and looking online on the fold line and different pattern websites and fabric shop websites, and I'm just drawing a bit of a blank, to be honest, with what I'm looking for. So yes, any ideas, send them my way. And the other thing I want to do with my sewing is just to try and get on top of using Stash Hub. I've got all of my fabrics, most of my fabrics, on Stash Hub. So I don't have any of my jerseys that I've kind of put aside for Taylor. I've got those in boxes ready to get onto Stash Hub at some point. But I've got all of my fabrics on there. And next, I want to get all of my patterns on there so that I can actually use all of the different functions that Stash Hub offers. So the project planning, I can't really do because I don't have many patterns uploaded onto there. So I'm on a mission this year to get all of my sewing patterns onto Stash Hub, which is a stash organization app, if you weren't aware. And then I'll be able to link my fabrics and my patterns together and make project plans and really get the best out of the app to help me in my sewing practice. So yes, what are your goals for 2024 in terms of sewing? I'd love to hear from you. So should we dive in with a few of the things I received for Christmas or that I've picked up recently? So I've kind of got everything down here. I'm just going to start grabbing things and sharing them with you. Okay, I'm going to start with my wonderful husband, because he really surprised me in the best possible way. So he bought me some fabric, and that's not something that he usually does. And I was quite taken aback and very, very, very impressed with what he got. The first piece of fabric was from Fabric Godmother, and it's one that I have eyed up and just adored since it was released. I love the colours, I love the design, it's beautiful. And it is this one. Isn't it just absolutely stunning? I really, really love it. I love the stars, I love the pink and the green. It's just a really beautiful, beautiful fabric. Now, bless him, when, it's very slippy for me to hold. When I opened this, Sam said, oh, I thought I was ordering you 2 meters. So I put 2 into the box on the website, and when it arrived, it was only 1 meter because I discovered that it's sold in 0.5 meters. Yes, I'm sure, Sam, you're not the only one that has done that and had that problem. But I've got 1 meter of this, which means I can definitely make some sort of beautiful top out of this. I'm thinking maybe the Sicily slip dress, but as a top, I think that would look really beautiful with the cowl and the really thin straps. I think that would look stunning. So something like that in this fabric. So didn't he do well? Then the next one that I opened from Sam was like 2 presents put together. So I think he told me to open this one first. Did he? Can't remember. It's a pattern from the Fold line. So I was like, wow, Sam's ordered me a pattern. That's really unusual and quite brave, really, because I do have a lot of patterns, and for him to choose something that A, I would like, and B, that I didn't already have, was gonna be quite a task. But he managed it. So in here, I won't show you it all, but it's an A0 printed pattern. And when I actually looked at the name, I had never heard of this pattern before. Or maybe I had, but it, you know, wasn't on my wavelength. So it's the Fiber Mood Leah, which is this absolutely gorgeous jumpsuit, boiler suit kind of vibe. On the Foldline website, it's described as a classic workwear overall that has been turned into something special with details like top stitching, chest pockets, and commodious hip pockets. Commodious. I've never heard of that word before. Wear it loose and oversized or belted at the waist with the self fabric tie for a feminine touch. I love this, and I think it will actually really suit me. And I think Sam has done so well choosing me this pattern. And then he's bought me fabric to go with it. And the fabric he's chosen is this gorgeous, it's from Sew Me Sunshine, this gorgeous denim. Just a really lovely dark denim, which as a jumpsuit, a boiler suit, is just going to look beautiful. So I'd really like to get that sewn up quite soon because that will be perfect in this colder weather. And I really want to do it justice because it's just one of the most thoughtful presents that anyone's ever bought for me. And I really want to show my appreciation by getting it made up, not putting it in the stash, and yeah, wearing it and loving it and showing it off. So I got a couple of books as well. This one was from my sister-in-law, so Sam's sister, and she bought me this one for my birthday, and it's by Mary Jane Baxter, Sew on the Go, A Maker's Journey. I'd never actually seen this book before, but I'm really intrigued and excited. Let me know if you have read it. On the back it says, one summer, Mary Jane Baxter finally did it. She quit her job and headed for the hills. Her home was an upcycled 1986 Bedford Bambi camper van with a top speed of 60 miles per hour. Raiding skips for vintage wallpaper and scouring secondhand emporiums for stylish accessories, she created her own mobile studio for crafting on the road. So yeah, then she goes travelling. I'm not going to read every single thing. She goes travelling around Belgium, Italy, France, Scotland, and she's got a trusty hand-cranked Singer. She spent a few months sewing on the go, meeting artists, holding pop-up craft events, and foraging in local markets. Inspiration was everywhere. So it also features 26 easy to achieve craft projects you can try with or without a sewing machine. So this is going to be really, really interesting. I'm so excited to get started reading that. Oh, the weather. Can you see on that window? The weather is dreadful. I then got a beautiful gift from Sue, who is one of my lovely sew tuners. She comes to pretty much all of my socials now, which is wonderful. And she gave me a gift for Christmas, and when I opened it, it was this amazing named clothing building the pattern book, which I don't have. I'm really excited about, because I think in this it has a jumpsuit that I really like. Yeah, the Varma jumpsuit. So it's got some beautiful patterns in this book, and I'm really excited to get started with this one. So thank you so much, Sue. It was such a thoughtful gift and just really, really lovely to receive. Then just a couple of things I've picked up for myself. I saw on the new Craft House Instagram the other day, they were putting together and selling sweatshirt kits with a really cool patch to pop on the front. So this patch is forever handmade, and it's got these hands making this heart. And they had lots of different colours, and you got the sweatshirting, you got the ribbing, and you got the thread to match as well. And they were really well priced. I think this kit came out, including postage, at something like £25, which I just thought was really, really great. So I went for the red, because I don't have any red jumpers, and actually red is a colour that I think really suits me. So I've got this beautiful red loop back sweatshirting. It's really, really soft actually, and just got that loop back finish on the reverse. So that's for the sweatshirt. Then you got your ribbing fabric as well, and then your thread, and the patch to pop on the front. So the idea is that you then make whichever sweatshirt pattern you want. And there were two different sizes of kit, a medium and a large, and it gave you the quantities for those. I went for the medium. The fabrics are actually really wide, so the quantities that they gave I thought would be enough for any sweatshirt pattern really that I want to make. So I'm really excited about getting started with that. Before Christmas, I treated myself to a couple of fabrics from Beyond the Pink Door. There was one that I'd seen on the Cloth Edit website, and I loved it. It was a Liberty fabric. And then when I spotted it on Beyond the Pink Door, I just bought it. And then there was also another fabric that I really liked. So these came recently. So the Liberty fabric is this one. I've got 1.5 meters of this, I believe. But I just loved that. It's got a very sort of graffiti-esque look to it, but the colours are beautiful. And then it's got the flowers that might be upside down, actually. It's got floral shapes and squiggly lines. And it's a Tana Lawn, which is just a really beautiful, soft cotton. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this. I could possibly make a Friday Pattern Company Donny shirt, just a nice little shirt, a cropped sort of style. Would be really nice in this, but I've got no firm plans, and I am wanting to only buy fabric with firm plans, but this one was just too good to miss. The other one I got was a loop back French terry, because I just loved the colours in this. So it's like an oil painting marbled effect with purples and blues, and I just thought that was really, really beautiful. I've got 1.5 meters of this as well, I think, and I want to make a sweatshirt or a sweater dress. Actually, it's a brushed back, so all of the loops have actually been brushed out, and it's got a beautifully soft and cozy feel. So yes, I think a sweater dress, if I've got enough, or just a sweatshirt, will be gorgeous in that one. So in terms of what I've been sewing up recently, I've made one complete thing, and then one thing is in progress. The complete thing is the Style Arc Phoenix sweatshirt. I've had this cut out for quite some time, maybe about 4 months, in a beautiful blue cable knit fabric, and I finally got it sewn up. So in between Christmas and New Year, I had a day where I could just dedicate a few hours to sewing, and I got this sewn up, and I really, really love it. I'm not going to go into loads of detail here, because I'm bringing back my makes and favourites videos at the end of each month. I'm going to be doing a roundup of everything I've made, where I'll talk in detail about the size that I made, any changes, anything I found difficult with the pattern. So I'm not going to go into that detail now, but I thought I would share it with you just so you can see. I love the style of this, the oversized style. I love those side panels and the pockets are really lovely, and I've worn this a few times now and it's super cozy. So yes, I do have plans to make at least one more of these. It's the perfect slouchy oversized sweatshirt to wear with leggings or skinny jeans, ultimate cozy vibes. The thing that I am almost finished but not quite is my Bernadette skirt by Friday Pattern Company. I started this at my sewing social the other day and I've done a little bit more on it today. This just needs to be hemmed. So this fabric was in last month's Sew Hayley Jane box. So it's up to that stage. It just needs to be hemmed. And then I just need to work on the belt bag. So the really cute little bag that goes on to a belt and will just give the finishing touch to this. I've added some really cute details by doing a bias bound facing on the inside. I'm actually going to film a little tutorial on how to do that. So keep your eyes peeled for that very soon. Got fun label in the back from Kylie and the Machine, and I'm loving that. So I tried it on once I'd inserted the zip. I would say it almost fits perfectly. It's slightly roomy at the waist, only slightly, but by the time I put the belt bag on and cinch that in a little bit, it'll be perfect. I am hoping to get that finished today or this week, definitely, with the belt bag on, and then I can share the finished make with you next week. In terms of what else I want to get sewn up this week, I've got a bit of a secret project that I'm working on getting finished. It's not a secret in that it's my collaboration with Becky from What Beck Sews. I've kept her waiting so long, I'm very, very sorry, but I had a complete change of mind, a change of heart about what I was going to make with the fabric, and therefore it's extended the length of time that it took to do. So yes, I'm hoping to get that finished this week as well, and then we can finally do our reveal. So Becky, I'm so sorry to have kept you waiting, and to everybody else also, I'm sorry for keeping you waiting. It is coming soon, I promise. The other thing that I'd like to definitely get finished is this bag. So this is the Blackbird Fabrics Bestie Bag, or BF Patterns actually, but it's by the same people who are Blackbird Fabrics. So it's their Bestie Bag, which is this gorgeous banana shaped crossbody bag that I was making for a friend's birthday. It's so nearly done. I just need to close up the gap on the inside and just finish off the strap here. But other than that, it's done. So I'd really like to actually get that ticked off, and then I can give it to my friend. She's only waited a couple of months now for this bag. I mean, she doesn't know she's getting it, but I know that it's very, very late. If you haven't received your Specky Seamstress subscription box yet this month, look away now, because I just want to share with you the design that came in this month's box, or envelope. It's a Bias Tape Appreciation Society, and this month is this really cute sewing makes me happy design with a little pin cushion, and I just think that's really, really adorable. So as you saw in my Bernadette skirt, I have used some bias on the waistband of that, and I'm planning on trying to incorporate bias into as many of my makes as possible this year, because I've got quite a collection and it's really fun and really straightforward to add to your makes. You just need to think about it and think about at what stage you are going to add it. So I'm trying to get into that habit so I can incorporate beautiful things like this into my garments or bags or whatever it is that I'm making. I just want to share something with you that has been sent to me. So Georgia, who is the Mendip maker over on Instagram, got in touch with the Northern Soul Sisters and asked if she could send us each a packet or a card of buttons. She's launched a button business, and they are recycled plastic buttons, and the little tagline is unique buttons that don't cost the earth, made from recycled plastic, HDPE and PP, including bottle tops, DVD cases, sweet tubs and other plastic products. That's really, really cool. So she's got a range of buttons in three different sizes and some really beautiful colours, and she asked myself, Ruan and Rachel to each choose one, and she would send them to us for free and for us to offer our thoughts to her. She didn't ask us to do any sort of reveal or showing them off, but she just wanted us to get in touch with her and let her know what we thought. But I obviously wanted to share them with you. I haven't used them yet because I've just opened the envelope, but they're really gorgeous. I actually couldn't decide between three of the colours, so I said to Ruan, please can you choose for me? And she's made a very good choice. She's gone with these teal ones. Hopefully you can see just how beautiful they are. All of those different swirls of colour. So these are the smallest size, which are 13 mil, and they're really, really beautiful. So I will link to George's Instagram and also where you can buy these buttons on both eBay and Etsy, and you can go and have a little look. Oh, there's so many things to talk about today. I'll just mention very quickly, in case you're not aware, that there are two new sewing podcasts that have started this year. One is So What's New in the Biscuit Tin, which is Jess from So What If I Sew and Sam from Sequin Girly Creates. They have teamed up, they have formed this really lovely friendship. They live very locally to each other and they've become really good friends, and they've decided to start a podcast to talk lots and lots about sewing, which is something we all love to do, right? So I really enjoyed listening to their first episode. They're doing fortnightly episodes and I can't wait for the next one. So do go and check that one out. And the other one is the So Disorganized Pod, which is Mari. She has an Instagram and also a YouTube channel, but she's now started a podcast, which is fabulous. She's doing weekly episodes. So I listened to the new episode today, which was fantastic. I really enjoyed the first episode as well, which was all about trends for this year. So do go and check out both of those podcasts if you like to listen to people talking about sewing, then I'm sure you'll find something for you. And finally, I think, does anybody remember a year or two ago when I said I really wanted to get into cross stitch? And then it never happened, did it? Well, I've finally gone and done it. I finally started my very first cross stitch project. So I purchased a cross stitch kit from the Knitting and Stitching Show at Harrogate, not the last one, but the previous one, so 2022, and it just went on a shelf and I never got around to doing it. It's a Christmassy themed one. It's a sloth in a Santa hat and it says slow ho ho, and I never got around to doing it. And then in between Christmas and New Year, I just really fancied some calm, mindful sewing and I picked it up and I'm really pleased that I did. So I'll show you what I've done so far. The feeling that I got as soon as I started to stitch, this just feeling of calm came over me and I was like, wow, is this what it's like to do something mindful and, you know, like cross stitch or embroidery, something really calming. And yeah, I'm really happy that I finally got started. So this is my progress so far. I'm using my Beyond the Pink Door Generates needle minder, which came in our advent calendar. But yeah, I'm making good progress so far, and I'm keeping all of my bits and bobs, my thread, my scissors, my pattern, in this adorable little caddy packer, which Adam sent me as a gift just before Christmas. It's a perfect size. But then I knew that I was going to be moving on to a bigger cross-stitch project after this one. So I got in touch with Adam and said, could I please order a project bag big enough for a larger cross-stitch kit? And within about 12 to 18 hours of me asking him, he'd made it, and it's absolutely stunning. So you've got the vinyl there, you've got this beautiful, beautiful cat fabric. Then on the back, oh, it's just beautiful. It's all the colours I love. It's just gorgeous, Adam. So thank you so much. You've got a lovely little paw print zip pull. Just everything about it I absolutely love. I purchased this from Adam, this wasn't a gift. I love it. So if you want a project bag, do get in touch with him because I'm so happy with that. And then I asked on Instagram for some recommendations for all things cross stitch, and people gave me a few ideas, one of which was Caterpillar cross stitch, which I've been checking out and will definitely be getting involved with or ordering from. And then a local, or a couple of local cross stitch companies to me actually. One is Innocent Bones, who I have ordered something from, but that won't arrive till later on in the month, I don't think. And then the other one was Truvail, I think that's how you say it, Truvail stitch kits. So this is the little business card. And then I ordered a couple of local Landmark kits. These were reduced in the sale, so I ordered the Tyne Bridge and I also ordered the Angel of the North. So I'm really excited about getting started with those. We've got a few prints and things up around our house with local landmarks on, so they will be perfect to frame and pop on the wall once they are done. If you have any cross stitch recommendations, do pop them down below. I'm really keen to get involved in more cross stitching. I'm wondering if there's many people who do cross stitch YouTube stuff. I haven't actually searched for it yet. I know that's probably what I should do first. But if you watch any cross-stitch YouTubers, I'd love to hear from you if that's a thing. But anything, any recommendations, any advice, do let me know. It's been really, really lovely catching up with you today. This was a bit of a bumper Friday sews because, as I said earlier, it was about 3 weeks worth of Friday sews to catch up on. So I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you have liked what you've seen. And if you have enjoyed the video, do give it a thumbs up and hopefully you'll join us here more often for more on this channel. I hope you're all really well and I'll see you again soon in my next video. Happy sewing, bye. I'm getting flipping notifications all the time and it's driving me mad. So yes, if you've got any, I've got a couple more things, but I'm gonna share those. And then I can actually, hey, it's like I forget how to do stuff.